Oskaloosa is getting closer to having a dog park. Organizers are reaching out to the city, hoping it will support their efforts. I spoke to Oskaloosan R.D. Keep, who heads up the dog park task force, to find out more.
The idea for a dog park in Oskaloosa started as a project for R.D. Keep's business management master's program at William Penn. He began to study dog parks around the country and the effect they have on the community.
We found out that the more dogs that are exercised, then the less aggressive they become. If you have less aggressive dogs, you have less barking complaints that law enforcement gets called out about.
Keep says there has also been complaints in Oskaloosa about pet waste being left at local parks in grassy areas. Keep surveyed more than 150 local dog owners to find out if there was community interest in the project.
Overwhelmingly, they said that we certainly need a park. We need a place where we can legally take our dogs off the leash and let them run.
Dog owner Georgetta Leek agrees.
I think that having a space where animals can socialize is a good idea, both for the animals' behavior and for the community in general, because poorly behaved animals are not a good idea for anyone.
The task force is discussing a number of land options for the dog park, but the current front runner is 1715 3rd Avenue East, where the old Kmart used to be. It's currently owned by a bank in Omaha.
And this property here has been vacant for over 20 years. We can clean up and we can begin to turn something that's really been unproductive area into a productive area again.
As of right now, the task force wants to put in 3 fenced-in areas at the dog park of about 1 acre each. There'll be an area for smaller dogs to run around in, an area for larger dogs, and an area for dog training. The task force's name for the park, the Barking Lot.
Keep says he's not sure yet how much the dog park will cost, but he hopes to have it up and running and ready for dogs by this Labor Day.
And good news for taxpayers, the dog park task force isn't looking to the city for money to build the park. The task force hopes to buy land and build the dog park with private donations and grants. The city would own and maintain the property as well as represent the task force in purchasing land.